Hi everyone and welcome back to our channel, the number one place for designers, artists and creators. I'm Jacqueline and I'm an interior architect and designer here at DMB. So today I wanted to uncover and delve into BIM, or in its full name, Building Information Modelling. It's a type of design software feature that allows you to see a building's physical and functional characteristics. That being said, let's jump into the video. As designers, architects, and engineers, we're constantly on the lookout for the newest thing that's going to help us improve our skills and decrease the amount of time we spend on a project. Over 50 years ago, building information modelling was created, but it's only until the early 2000s it really started to get recognised, and now it's taking over the design space. This year, Germany mandated the use of BIM in all of their transportation projects. So if you're new to this term, what does it actually mean? So BIM can be defined as an intelligent 3D modelling process that allows multiple bits of information to be laid onto one model or project. For example, back in the day, the classic method of drafting, you know, with a pen and a paper, would be the go-to method for compiling all types of information for a project. Then came CAD, a software that revolutionised AEC. And now BIM has been created, the future of design, a mixture of both 3D and 2D software and so much more. It combines a series of integrated models and services rather than a set of separate drawings. This is incredibly useful, especially on bigger projects, because designers, architects and engineers and contractors even are able to work more cohesively on a project and change the project with ease. So what sort of things does a BIM software include? It includes things like the renovation stage, programming, concept design, a detailed design, construction and structural analysis, operation and maintenance, fabrication, and it also offers types of rendering services as well, so that it makes it easy for you to create realistic visualizations for clients. Here's the interesting part, the actual benefits of BIM. Why is it so much better than other types of older software? I think one of the first points is that it allows for communication and collaboration really easily compared to older softwares. These days on BIM softwares, you can upload projects to a certain cloud and colleagues and designers from all across the world can collaborate and edit a project. You can also create quick and detailed renders. Rather than having to use AutoCAD and then transfer it to 3ds Max or any other type of rendering software, the combination of 2D and 3D elements allows for much more efficiency when it comes to visualizations. Another really important thing that it can do is that it can pinpoint hazards before they become a problem, and that can ensure for the safety across the whole of the project's execution. In the same light, it can detect mistakes, for example, an electrical conduit or ductwork that run into a beam, so it will let you know anything like that. By modelling all of these things early, clashes can be discovered and altered so that you don't have those later on costly on-site clashes. I would say that if you're still in that CAD era, I would definitely invest in a BIM software to really enhance your design skills and also safety of projects. It's about quality control at the end of the day. So what are the types? You have Revit, which I'm sure most of you American viewers have heard of. You've got Rhino, which is really good for visualization work, ArchiCAD, which says it in the name, it's a good software for architects, and Vectorworks, which is actually the one I use, and it's really good for its endless amount of BIM features. Obviously, these are just a few programs, and there are many out there, but these are seemed as like the best in the market. And if you're interested in any of the ones I've just said, I've linked the descriptions of all of them down below if you want to find out a bit more information. I'm sure that developments within GIS, VR and drone technology will really develop BIM in the near future and make it become a commodity within the design and build industry. If you're new, then welcome. This channel is all about interior design, architecture, illustration, graphic design and art. So if any of that interests you, make sure to subscribe to see videos just like this one. And if you like this video, then please give it a big thumbs up, because by doing that, you really do support our channel. Okay guys, thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.